So basically, I first read up about the place that I'm going to shoot, and also if it is like if I'm just going for shooting the place or like a landscape thing, and whatever animal or bird I find is a bonus, or if I'm going to a particular forest to see one species only. In which case, I make it a habit to read about the species, its behavior, to understand what are its unique characteristics. So I do a lot of research in the beginning of the shoot so that I'm well prepared on the field and nothing surprises me as such. And again, I make a note of the weather as to what all conditions will affect the photographic scenario, you know, because like for fireflies, for example, I had to check the moon timetable as well, because moon set and moon rise, because I wanted to have no ambient light affecting the picture. And hence I made sure that when I reached there, the moon would have already set, or it was like really in the waning stage, so that it doesn't affect my photograph. So these are some things, like for example, for tigers, maybe what you can keep in mind is that when you go to a tiger sanctuary during summers, you have a much better chance of spotting the striped stalker instead of, you know, going in monsoons or in winters, because yes, the feel of the forest is completely different. And if you see a tiger in the winter, possibly with the fog and everything, you'll have a mind-blowing picture. But if you really want to photograph it for an assignment as such, then I would say go in summers, because you are more guaranteed of seeing the tiger then, because they come to water holes to quench their thirst. Very important. I feel really that photography cannot be complete without storytelling, because ultimately, what are you trying to do with your images? You are telling a story of what you have seen out there in the wild. So if I just take a picture of a tigress with a cub, that picture itself tells the story of the big cat's behavior in the wild. So every picture to me has to tell a story, no matter be it a portrait, be it a landscape shot, a wide angle, any other, you know, type of shot, but it has to definitely evoke emotions in people, and that will obviously come when there is a story attached to it. I feel it's very important. In fact, being an advertising student myself, branding is one of the key aspects that you have to, you know, kind of master for a product in terms of a company. So when I look at personal branding from a photographer's point of view, I feel it's important because you need to, as a photographer, you need to project yourself as a brand to other bigger brands like, say, Discovery, or to Animal Planet, National Geographic, all these big channels. So for me, I really invest in personal branding using social media. I feel that is a good way to, you know, one, connect with your followers, your fans, and also a good platform where you can showcase your style, your approach to a project as such. And all the projects I feel that you take up as in your whole journey as a photographer add to your personal brand as well.